Norwalk Emergency Department. Welcome to the 2021 holiday party for Norwalk Emergency Department. Thank you all for coming. If everyone can move forward a little bit, we have to take a little break. We're going to have some musical offerings from our own Dr. Taktakishvili. A little assistance from Heather.
A lot of assistance.
A lot of assistance.
Hey, hey, hey! Hi, everybody! Mic sounds a little, okay. Well, oh, there we go. Okay, yeah, that's a lot better. All right, welcome, everybody. Welcome to the legendary Norwalk Emergency Department holiday party. And it's so nice to see everybody here. Well, you know what? Cheers to us all being here in person, right? In person is pretty awesome. I told Ari it would be much easier to do this on Zoom, but he had to schedule this whole thing, but I think with good effect, I like it. Well, as you can tell, I've dusted off my little old guitar and brought it down. So we can play a little bit of a couple of songs here. Really, the only reason I brought it down is to play this song. All right, that's it. That's all I know. And good night, everyone. Thank you. Actually, I did think about what to play for you guys, and I think a song that came to mind over and over and over again was this one, Heather. You know this one. Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun. I said, it's alright. Should we play that one? I don't think so. I mean, we hear that one every time a COVID patient gets discharged. We hear that song. So. Alright, instead, here we go. Okay, we got one hand. Anybody else? Oh, Jeremy, all right. Well, listen, and who wants to save the man's life? Save the man's life. All right, go against the Johnny Cash. All right, good. So, listen, the ones of you who raised your hand for Let the Man Die, you've had too much to drink. Okay, you're cut off, bartender, no more. And the rest of you guys, you got to keep an eye on them, because they're obviously... So I said we change the words a little bit. So let's just make a slight modification here. So it goes something like this. I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, never play with guns, and shot a man in the wristboard, just to watch him die. And then I called him a lunch caller, because of course he fit all the trauma alert criteria. He was hypotensive in the field, and you know, he was shot in the torso, and you know, when he arrived to the emergency department, we were all there waiting for him, and you know, we weren't just all crowded in the trauma room like a bunch of cattle. We actually assigned roles, and the ED physician was at the head of the bed, and the trauma physician was at the foot of the bed, and the trauma physician was a female.
Yes!
And you know, everything ran so smoothly that within something like 20 seconds, we had the GCS, and we had all the vital signs done on the guy. You know, including a rectal temperature, and you know, we turned him and we got like 6 IVs on the guy, and he got 6 units of blood. Alright! And then he went to CAT scan and he died. Oh. No, he didn't die. You know. He got admitted to medicine. Hospital's medicine. And then when he got discharged, they played this song. Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun. I said, it's alright. It's alright. Alright everybody, we don't need no education. Somebody help me. Somebody help me. Here we go. Okay, here we go. Who knows how to do CPR?
Think about all the folks that are over in the air right now.
taking care of the people around the morning. So this song goes out to my special person who's working in the ER tonight, who works every day, I think, in the ER of her life. She's probably worked 100,000 shifts. See if you can figure out what I'm talking about.
Oh, Really, truly, this experience was really excellent from start to finish. and that includes the valet parking as well. You should be proud and know how good your team is. That's from our patients. So the doctors and the staff were very kind and compassionate to my needs. Very clear explaining what needed to be done when I was leaving the emergency department. I left the ED feeling physically and mentally better than when I came in. I highly recommend the Norwalk Emergency Department. So, but I try to do just the best because it represents everything that we've been doing. Everyone we spoke with was friendly, attentive, and helpful. Shannon was a PA who saw my daughter and provided excellent care. It helped us with follow-up and obtaining the medication that my daughter needed. Shannon went far and above and beyond, and we were extremely grateful. The medical staff was excellent, even though they were short staffed and overwhelmed. Dr. Capodanno was prompt, thoughtful, and informative. My nurses, Daryl, Emily, and Liz Price, I'm very thankful to the staff and nurses. Dr. Taktakishvili, during this scary time and difficult time, and for the care and attention they provided my son, who is only 4 years old. This was a stark contrast to the service, or lack of, that we received at the COVID Children's Hospital in New York for the same exact issue. Here's just a random thought. The chairs are comfortable, and I sat in them for 9.5 hours. The nurses were friendly and efficient. She was outstanding. Immediate attention and feedback from Dr. Perkins. Great coverage by the nurses. ER doctor, Dr. Greenman, and my nurse, Paulina, was wonderful. Was exceptional at detective work. Dominique, the nurse, was fabulous. What a terrific team. The care and dedication of the nurses, they were truly amazing. Shout out to Cassie. My heartfelt thank you. I checked in before shift was finished. And when night shift nurse left at 7 a.m., she came in to tell me, have a nice day. And for a second, I was speechless. With a busy night, still had the time to say hello to everyone for the night. God bless her. The triage nurse, Kathleen. Don't remember her last name. She was proficient, adept, and kind. So once again, I was examined, treatment, and care and received by the doctor, the PA, and the nurses were exceptional. The PA, Erica, and the nurse, I said Vinny, so I don't remember they referred to. That work that night was great in the ER. Just a couple more, and then we'll get back to the party. The clinical assistant, I think the name was Ryan, was extremely helpful. The ER, Caitlin and Dr. Chow. Your entire experience gave me a deep confidence. Not just the level of care and the interaction I had with 5 to 10 staff in total, but the efficiency and the teamwork of the department. So, now the fun part. Okay, so I always like to give you an example just in case. We always talk about being on staff in the emergency department, and we usually hear about that in terms of somebody's heard us saying something and we're not paying attention to them, but they are paying attention to us. They're looking at this. We get these every 2 weeks. Please feel free to reach out to me and say we can share these. We'll do better about sharing these throughout the year if we're not paying them. So now for the tech of the year. You see, these are difficult, and we have, I'll do runner-ups. So we have runner-up, we had runner-up. This was a three-way tie.
A three-way.
Ryan, Aaron, and Victoria. For the second year, we had a tie. We had Lucy and Tom.
A very sharply dressed, handsome gentleman today, Dr. Greenblatt. Oh, Dr. Jason Greenblatt. I don't know if you heard the vote. You're so handsome today, so you can't win. I would jealousy, I would go with you can't win. So the position of the year that the team voted for this evening is Ernest.
Incredible job. Let's hear it for our PA, please. please. PAs. So this year, the PA of the year goes to Elizabeth.
Damn right.